Hello friends, I am S.R. Dulange, working as an associate professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we will discuss on cost of quality, or we can say cost of poor quality. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, student will be able to apply and analyze the cost associated with quality while manufacturing. Contents: introduction, components of cost of quality, two kinds of cost, references. Introduction, definition of cost of quality: methodology that allows an organization to determine its resources, which are used for activities that prevent poor quality, that appraise the quality of the organization's product or service, and that result from internal and external failures. Now, in this definition, there are four keywords. One is prevention, second is appraisal, third is internal and external failure. So, having such information allows an organization to determine the potential savings to be gained by implementing process improvements. So these are the components of cost of quality. So these are divided into four. One is prevention cost, second is internal failure cost, third is appraisal cost, fourth is external failure cost. Now what is prevention cost? So it is a cost to prevent or avoid quality problems. So there are certain costs which comes under prevention. For example, quality planning. So quality planning is the planning of the production before it has to be manufactured. So under that, market research, product development, inspection plan, which is related with the quality planning. Documenting, manuals and procedures in order to achieve the quality. Process control, to control the process by making use of statistical tools and to control the variability in the process. Quality assurance, assurance of quality in work in process. Investigation of the quality during the raw material to the product stage, and training the manpower in order to get a good quality. Second is appraisal cost. So this is the cost of measuring and monitoring activities related to quality. So in this quality audit system, whether it is performing correctly or incorrectly, it has to be audited. The supplier is supplying the material, so the supply rating is to be done through the assessment and the approval. Inspection and the test, that is inspecting equipment, should be maintained at high level of calibration. Maintenance and calibration of the machines is also important. The third is internal failure cost, incurred to remediate defects discovered before the product is delivered. So this is on the production floor. So the defects which are coming out of the production is to be avoided on the shop floor during the process. So first is waste. Waste is a result of poor planning, unnecessarily movement or the work, errors which are caused in the process. Failure analysis, that is the cause of internal product failure. Scrap is which cannot be repaired. Then rework, where the more work is necessary in order to get a product. External failure cost, incurred to remedy defects discovered after the product is delivered. Means the product is now with the customer. So here repairs and servicing, warranty claims, complaints and returns. So this is related with the customer. Now the customer is paying the money, and if the product is not suitable, then reputation of the firm will deteriorate. Now for a moment, think which cost is positive cost and which cost is dangerous cost. In my opinion, the positive cost is prevention cost, because it prevents the cost required in order to get the good quality. And which cost is dangerous cost? Now, the reputation of the firm is dependent on the external failure cost. So, if the product is returned by the customer, then that is very dangerous. So, this cost is called as dangerous cost. Now, these are the components of cost of quality. If suppose the appraisal cost increases, what will happen? It produces a lot of defects. External failure cost increases, what will happen? Producing lots of defect. Internal failure cost increases, it producing lot of defect. Now, to consider the cost of quality, we must have to concentrate on these three costs. One is appraisal cost, second is external failure cost, and third is internal failure cost. So, this should be kept minimum in order to come to a product wherein the products are within the specifications. Now, there are two kinds of cost. One is a visible and another is a hidden. Now, certain costs are visible, as we have seen in the prevention cost, in the internal failure cost, in the external failure cost, in the appraisal cost. The certain costs are visible and certain costs are hidden cost. Actually, the hidden costs are more as compared to the visible cost. So, in order to get a high quality product, we must have to concentrate on this hidden cost. So, what are these hidden costs? Change, engineering changes in order. So, if suppose you change the design frequently, then that results in a high cost. If the cycle time is high or long, then it results in high cost. Time value of money. So, production should be done with a minimum time or the optimum time. Long setups. If the setups are more, then the cost associated with that will be more. Working capital required will be high if suppose we keep more inventory. If we lose the customer loyalty, in that case it will be having an impact on the organization reputation. Excessive material handling or the planning or the order also leads to the high cost. Excess inventory which is kept in the store or just in time is the technology which is used in order to overcome this excess inventory. Late delivery, if the product is delivered lately to the customer, so it is a loss of reputation for the firm. Lost sales, these sales which are lost due to these hidden costs are more. There are certain visible costs. One is a rejection, second is a warranty, third is a inspection, fourth is a scrap, and fifth is a rework. Rejection leads to the high cost of the product because the manufacturing cost increases. So, warranty claim by the customer is the bad reputation for the company. Inspection cost must be optimum. So, to get the optimum inspection cost, generally, acceptance sampling is used instead of 100% inspection. The scrap must be avoided because the scrap is negative for the every organization. Rework should be minimum because sometimes it may happen that rework is essential. It has to be kept minimum. So, it is necessary to have a minimization of the visible as well as the hidden cost. So, this is about the cost of quality, and these are the references.